Hello, it's Grammy from Grammy and Grandpa Reads, and today I have a book for you called Great Granny Rose and the Family Christmas Tree. It's written by Anne Edwards Cannon and illustrated by Jacqui, Grothe. Great Granny Rose was so old that her hair was as white as snow and her face was seamed with wrinkles. When Joey was four, asked her how old she was, she smiled and said, "Older than the trees in my front yard." Great Granny Rose, things were old too. The wedding ring on her finger was worn thin. The couch by the window where she sat to catch the sun on her shoulders was faded. The Bible she kept on the low table had pages as brittle and dry as last year's leaves. Even Great Granny's Rose's cat, Moses, was old. He didn't bother even chasing mice anymore, but preferred sitting next to Great Granny Rose and flicking his tangerine tail. Joey liked Moses and Great Granny Rose's house and Great Granny Rose too. One Saturday in December, Joey and Dad took Great Granny Rose a Christmas tree and set it in a sturdy stand near the window, not far from the couch. "How do you like your Christmas tree?" Dad asked in a loud voice as he filled the stand with water. Great Granny Rose looked at it with her cloudy blue eyes and blinked, but she didn't answer. Dad went to the hall closet and pulled down a big brown box from the top shelf. He placed it in by the tree and Joey wondered what was inside. "We'll help you decorate later," said Dad, "but I have some errands to run right now." "It isn't alive," Great Granny Rose finally said. "Excuse me?" Dad looked confused. "The tree, it isn't alive." "Oh, but it is," Dad answered. "Smell it." Great Granny Rose, that fresh Christmas tree smell all right. Then he walked to the couch and dropped a kiss on Great Granny Rose's snow-white head. "Goodbye for now. Joey really wanted to see what was in the box. Can I stay?" he asked. "Please? Please?" Granny Rose echoed. Dad looked at both of them and looked at his watch. "Fine, I'll be back in an hour." As soon as the door shut, Joey raced over to the big brown box and removed the lid. Inside were Christmas ornaments, dozens and dozens of them, shining and still as pirate's treasure. Carefully, Joey lifted an ornament and looked at it. The clouds in Great Granny Rose's eyes parted. "Now that was my mother's. She hung it on her own tree when she was a very young married woman in England. She and my father lived in a lovely little cottage in Bristol with china and fine furniture. But when they heard the missionaries, they decided to come to America, where I was born. They sold many of their possessions, although not quite everything." Joey took the ornament out. Joey took the ornament from long ago and hung it on the tree. Then he lifted another from the box. "Now that was on the tree when I was a girl," said Great Granny Rose. "On Christmas Day, my brothers and I hitched up the horse to a great sleigh ride. Then we went skating on the lake with friends. After all, drank hot cider." Joey took the ornament from long ago and hung it on the tree. Then he lifted another from the box. "Now that was your grandmother's favorite ornament when she was a little girl," said Great Granny Rose. "Times were terrible and hard. It was the Great Depression and strong men couldn't find work. We were lucky. My husband had a job with the railroad. Joey took the ornament from long ago and hung it on the tree. Then he lifted another from the box. Now that ornament was your father loved to play with. I remember the year he found a cowboy hat and a holster with two cap guns waiting for him beneath the Christmas tree. He looked just like you look now. Joey took the ornament from long ago and hung it on the tree. Then he lifted another from the box. His favorite, no doubt about it. Now that was the ornament some special young man made for me with his own hands, said Great Granny Rose. Who would that be? That would be me. He took the ornament from not so long ago and hung it on the tree. Then he hung more until the box was empty and the tree was full. Slowly, very slowly, Great Granny Rose stood up and joined Joey. He slipped one hand over his. Together they stood and looked at the green branches, bobbing and brimming with glass balls and bells and beads and painted birds. And now, announced Great Granny Rose, my tree is alive. Isn't that a great story? All of the different ornaments had a story behind them. Do you have some special ornaments that have stories behind them? I hope that you will like this video and subscribe to our channel.